Hello, I'm Mohammed Hassan, the Quantum Solutions Planning Lead at Keysight.
Welcome to our video demo on designing superconducting qubits using QuantumPro in PathWave EDS 2024. In this tutorial, I will walk you through the process of designing and simulating superconducting qubits for quantum computing applications. Let's get started. Launch PathWave EDS 2024 and open the design flow examples. Scroll down to Quantum and open the single qubit chip workspace. The goal of this example is to analyze a circuit consisting of a transmon pocket and a readout resonator and obtain the quantum parameters. Starting from the schematic view, you can drag and drop components from the built-in library such as transmon pocket, CBW, mineral lines, coupling capacitors, and input-output launch pads to build the circuit as shown here. The layout can be automatically generated from the schematic through layout generate update layout within the schematic view. In the layout, it is essential to add a boundary box as it defines later the ground plane in the electromagnetic analysis. The boundary box can be created by inserting a rectangle into the boundary layer. We can open the predefined substrate from the substrate editor and edit it if needed. We open next QuantumPro by going to Tools, QuantumPro Open to complete the electromagnetic setup. In QuantumPro, we offer two types of analysis, namely the full EM analysis, which allows for a frequency sweep of the circuit with the input and output ports. Returning the S parameters, in this analysis, we support both the finite element method and the method of moments. The second type of analysis is the energy participation one, which allows for finding the eigenmode of the system. In this analysis, we support only the FEM solver. Next, to complete the setup, drag and drop pins to make the port excitations for the frequency domain analysis. You will also need to drag and drop qubit lambda inductances to get them as components in both the frequency domain and energy participation analyses. Additionally, the quantum circuit requires a special meshing because of the minute CPW features. The mesh should be refined to approximately 200 cells per wavelength from the default 20 cells per wavelength. For better simulation accuracy and to capture the capacitive effects around the transmon pocket, it is recommended to increase the mesh density near the pockets. Now, for the energy participation analysis in the advanced simulator, the target mesh size should be set to automatic overriding the conductor to 5 microns. This secures at least 2 mesh elements per the width of the CBW line. Next is to define the frequency range of the simulation for the full EM analysis under Frequency Plans tab in QuantumPro Setup. The start and the stop frequencies are set to sweep adaptively from 1 to 10 GHz, while for the energy participation analysis, the frequency range can be specified under the Option tab. There are two fundamental modes in this particular quantum circuit, one for the qubit and the other for the resonator. It is important to set the number of eigenmodes at least equal to the number of fundamental modes of the circuit. Furthermore, the field data are required for the calculation of the quantum parameters in the energy participation analysis. Therefore, the save option needs to be checked. The quantum parameters in superconducting circuits describe the qubit anharmonicity and the cross-curve values between the qubit and the readout resonator. In order to extract the quantum parameters after the simulation, you simply double-click extracted parameters for both the frequency domain and the energy participation analyses. Quantum parameters are expressed as n by n square matrix, where n represents the total number of extracted eigenmodes to the system. The diagonal elements in the matrix represent the unharmonicity, while the off-diagonal elements represent the cross curve. Here are some highlights from the results. Using the frequency domain analysis, you can see the S parameters of the circuit, while for eigenmode simulation, you can also find the field distribution for each mode in the circuit. Moreover, using the eigenmode solver of QuantumPro, it is possible to find the loaded quality factors for the different eigenmodes in the circuit and the associated photon lifetime, T1, by loading the circuit with the port impedances and then extracting the quantum parameters. One of the very powerful features of QuantumPro is the ability to iterate on the circuit using parametric sweeps. This is an example of how to do that. In the Project tab, go to Design and then find the component that you want to iterate on. For instance, here, let's iterate on the length of the readout resonator. We will need to set the length as a parameter, say LR. Now, in the setup of the analysis, you can double-click on options and then select the values of LR that you want to sweep on. Here, we will go from 6.5 mm to 7.5 mm in 0.5 mm step. Moreover, scaling up to a bigger circuit is easily achievable within QuantumPro. To illustrate, here is an instance of a circuit with 4 qubits and similarly one with 16 qubits. Meanwhile, our nonlinear co-simulation technique involves coupling the electromagnetic flow with the nonlinear circuit flow using Josephson junction models to accurately predict the power-dependent response of quantum chips. Here is an example. Using nonlinear co-simulation, we can accurately predict the dispersive shift of the readout signal as the power is ramped up. Last, but not least, QuantumPro allows for automatically creating a Python script for various setup items. For instance, you can simply right-click on the analysis and say create script, and then you will get the script automatically generated. You could then modify the script per your needs. PathWave EDS simplifies the process of designing superconducting qubits, allowing you to explore different configurations, simulate their behavior, and optimize performance for your quantum computing applications. Thank you for joining us in this PathWave EDS demo. For more information and to start designing your own superconducting qubits, visit our website or contact our support team. Happy designing!